new music, drama, and Christianity? All this and more in this week's Top Stories. This is Rob Menzer with the Metal Injection News Update, counting down this week's top stories in metal. We're going to start with something wholesome this week. Well, about as wholesome as we can get when Korn is involved. Nick Harrison, a.k.a. Mr. Professor 318 on TikTok, recently shared a clip of his new method for teaching the ABCs to his students. Just sing it to the tune of Coming Undone. It's truly a fun video and even caught the attention of Jonathan Davis himself. It looks like even Fred Durst is paying attention. Did anyone else forget that Serge Tankian and John Domain are related by marriage? I did. Well, that's not the story here. The story is Serge disagreeing with Domain's American political views, and I'm sure a lot of us can relate. In a recent interview with Consequence of Sound, he states, "I love and respect John very much, but I don't love and respect his American political views. They tried to cancel Eminem last week, and as usual, it's the aftermath that gets talked about." The short of it is, Eminem got called out for decade-old lyrics on TikTok, and now Corey Taylor, yes, Corey Taylor of Slipknot, has something to say about it. It sounds like he didn't read past the headlines on the matter, which seems to be the case with most of us lately. Alice in Chains guitarist Jerry Cantrell has completed a new solo record, the first in a whopping 19 years. Cantrell recently revealed that Dillinger's Escape Plan vocalist Greg Puciato is involved, as well as Robert Trujillo and Mike Borden. We can't wait for this one. Last week, we reported on the details of Alexi Lejo's passing as released by ex-wife Kimberly Goss, which it turns out his family would have preferred to keep private. In addition, there's an internal drama building in regards to Lejo's burial. We hope this can be resolved soon so that Lejo may properly rest. Max Cavalera is discussing his departure from Sepultura again, this time giving more detail than ever. In a recent Heavy 1 Hard Force radio interview, Cavalera spoke about the Roots era of the band and what led to the beginning of the split, focusing on a betrayal he felt from the band. Legendary in-tune vocalist LG Petrov recently lost his battle with cancer, passing on March 7th at the age of 49. The vocalist himself put it best when addressing his diagnosis. "Cancer doesn't have feelings, it's just maximum bad luck. Rest in peace, LG." If you like Cobra Kai, then you're familiar with actor Tanner Buchanan, who plays Robbie Keane on the show. What you may not be familiar with is that he used to play in a progressive metal act called Acidosis. Turns out they were huge Gojira fans and covered them on a regular basis, which is just impressive by itself. Howard Jones and Jared Dines just released their first single from their new band Scion. The track The Blade is accompanied by a new music video showcasing the two artists, and as per usual, Jones absolutely crushes it on vocals. Back in 2005, Korn guitarist Brian Head Welch left the band after finding Jesus and decided to dedicate his career to Christianity. He eventually rejoined in 2013, and now in a recent interview with Rob Flynn, he's saying he might have taken the whole Jesus thing a little too far. He compares his obsession with Jesus to being obsessed with drugs. That'll do it for this week's Top Stories in Metal. Head on over to metalinjection.net to read these stories and more in full. Which story made the biggest impact on your week? Let us know in the comments below. Is anyone else going to have the ABC stuck in their head all weekend, or is it just me? It's just me, isn't it?